Good morning, YouTube. So testing out my cooling fan controller board here. You can see the fan just cycled off. I have it set on the fixed mode, which I think turns on the fan at 30C and then ramps it up to full speed by 50C. So I think it's only getting up to the lowest speed here. I don't have the cover on yet, so it's just pulling a little bit of air over the heat sinks, but it is definitely cycling it on and off. So yeah, I have the temperature sensor for the cooling fan controller is right here, and then this is the temperature sensor for the inverter circuit board and the microcontroller. So there's a little closer look. So I bring DC voltage in from the inverter, run that up here. Underneath the board, I have a polarity protection diode, which was actually pretty handy because when I first put this connector on, I put it on backwards, and the diode did its job. It protected the circuit board, so I got that connector turned around. And then I've got an on-off switch here, so I can shut this thing off. Here's a DC jack for my digital thermometer, and I have the thermometer picking up the temperature on the transformer. I've got my 4-pin fan controller connector here. It's turned on by the fan 1 output of the controller, and I'm still working on this LED. This LED is turned on and off by the tachometer output of the fan. Still trying to get the current limiting resistor. I've got it down around 700 to 800 ohms, and I think I need to go a little bit lower to get the LED brightness up. But basically that LED will flicker a little bit to tell you that the fan is actually running. And then here there's the power LED, and then when the fan turns on, there's a second red LED that will also flicker, showing the pulse width modulation. And then this is the temperature sensor for the controller. And then the rest of the circuit board I've left empty for now. So yeah, what I'll probably do with this, I'm going to pick up some signals off of the control panel for the inverter, things like whether the inverter's on or off, and then also the contacts for the on-off switch. And then I'll use this connector for the remote on-off from the SBMS120. So essentially this signal here will tell me if I need to turn off the inverter, which I'll do through that connector. So I still have to build up that circuit. I need to prototype out some parts. I think the fan controller's working, so what I'm going to do is button this thing up, put the case back on. I'll mount the controller here on top of the case and get everything plugged in. But you can see the transformer's definitely warming up there, getting up close to 28C. This morning it was 20C when I turned it on. So yeah, I think this improved cooling system for the inverter is working okay. I can basically see when the fan is running from outside the unit. I don't have to have the cover off, because that was the main problem with the original system, is you could never tell if the fan was actually working unless it was on high speed, and the only time it was on high speed was if you had the full load up close to 1,000 watts running. And I rarely push this thing all the way to the limit, so I think that was part of the problem, was the fan had quit working at some point and I just never knew that it was broken. Yeah, you can see the blue LED flickering a bit. Actually, it shows up in the camera better than it shows up in person. But there you go. The blue LED flickering is the tachometer output of the cooling fan. So that's telling me the fan is physically spinning. And there it shut off. Now you can see the LED shut off. That's what I wanted, was something so that I can actually see what's going on here. And there you can see the fan shut off. It just cycles on and off, like it should, because with the original cooling fan controller on the main circuit board, the fan would not be running right now. It would be off, and it would stay off until you ran the load up over 200 watts, and I'm only at 130 watts. So I think that's my first pass at the controller board, so I've used up about half of my circuit board area for the cooling fan controller, and then I left about half the circuit board for my auxiliary functions, so I still have to work on getting that prototyped and figuring out what all I want to do, but for now, I think the cooling fan will really help this thing run. This fan does have less airflow than the original fan. I think it's around 40% of the airflow, so one thing I need to see is, will this fan keep it cool enough at higher loads? So that's one of the reasons I added this thermometer there, so I can actually do those tests. Because I know when I was running 130 watt load for a couple of hours, this transformer temperature was like 58 or 59 C. So I should be able to see if I reach that sort of temperature again. And hopefully I don't, because that was getting pretty warm. But yeah, I'll get this button back up and do some more testing on it, but I think that's a good first step. Definitely the fan is cycling on and off like it should. And apparently that airflow from that fan is enough to reduce the temperature on the heat sink. And then that causes the temperature controller to shut the fan off just like it's supposed to. So yeah, I think that's going to be a big improvement for this. And it's totally silent. I can't even hear that fan, and that's one of the reasons I wanted to add that external LED so that I could see if the fan's actually running or not, because this fan is very silent. But yeah, if you have any questions or feedback, post up in the comment section down below, and I'll put any updates over here on the left side. And as always, thanks for watching.